Generally, painting anything on your car is a bad idea. But if you're going to do it, you need to do it right and take your time. And that's the biggest thing, is taking your time. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna paint the headlight rings on my 2014 Chevy Sonic. But I'm gonna take my time, do it right, and it's gonna look great. So let's get started. The first thing with plastic is you wanna make sure it is super clean. So the best way to do this for these plastic parts is I could literally just take some dish soap, throw these things in the sink, and wash them down. Or another easier way is just to hit them with some glass cleaner, and that'll get most of the grease off and everything, but you really want to get all the grease off. Anytime you paint plastic, if the surface is not perfectly clean, you run into the chance that stuff is going to start to, your paint is going to peel. And in this case, that would suck, because I don't have a bunch of extra ones of these to do them three or four times. So I wanna get it right the first time. So very, very clean surface is the first place you wanna start. Whenever you talk about painting a complex but small plastic piece like this, a lot of people forget that it's not just the surface that you're gonna see that needs paint. Also, you need to clean the back surface as well. And the reason is because where is paint going to peel up, or where is it going to start to peel? It's going to start to peel in the places that you don't actually see it on your project, but there still is the edge of the paint. So I have to be careful to also make sure that the back part of this plastic piece is clean and the inside of the plastic piece is clean, because that is where it's really important for the plastic paint to stick so it doesn't start to peel from the outside and then peel into the front of your project. This is where things start to get a little tricky. I've cleaned my parts and they're ready to go for the most part, but if these parts weren't chrome, I would scuff them up just a tiny bit, probably with a Scotch-Brite pad or maybe a 1000 grit sandpaper, and then clean them again. That way I know that the paint is going to adhere. The reason I'm not going to do that with these parts is because they're already painted chrome, and I like the chrome color to come through underneath my next layer of paint. So I don't want to scuff it off too bad. So I'm leaving it on there and just making sure it's super, super clean. And then I'm going to use some adhesion promoter next, and that should give me a good surface, good adhesion with my paint. So the trick with adhesion promoter is less is more. You do not want to put a bunch of this on your project, just a super light coat. So there's a coat of adhesion promoter between your plastic and your paint. One of the most important things that I do with any project is if I have the ability to, I'm going to test before I actually do it on my actual project. So for this project, I've already did this. I can't find the one I tested on originally, but I wanted to try this type of paint on chrome and see what the color looks like. And what was really cool is if you notice, the actual chrome caps to a lot of spray cans are a great test piece to see exactly how the color is going to come out before you actually test it on your project. You can also test how thick you want your paint, not just if the color is going to be right. I actually tested several different paints and finally came up with wanting to use Duplicolor metal cast. I love this stuff. It's really cool, but I wanted to make sure it looks good on the chrome and didn't look too pink. I wanted it to be nice and red. So I tested it on my chrome piece. It looks really good. So we're ready to go. All right, remember, smooth strokes, super light coats. That's how you avoid any drips, any pools, any heavy spots. You can always go over it again. Less is more. So I know all the professional painters out there are turning over in their graves right now because you don't paint outside, but small projects, it's not a huge deal, and I don't have a lot of dust right here, so it's not a huge deal. Now, time for a clear coat. Hence why I said you should never paint outside, because you would never, any professional would never paint, especially clear coat outside, because it's just a bad idea. You're gonna get stuff all in the clear coat. For small projects, it's really not a huge deal. Now, spray can clear is always a nightmare, okay? I've done videos on it before. You just have to be very, very careful. The biggest thing is to try to stay within the same brand, but if you can't, that's not a huge deal. but make sure you look at the coating times from your spray spray can, and also do a very, very light first coat. That'll generally keep you from having all sorts of the weird problems that you can run into with clear coat. So I'm gonna do a super light first coat. And I'm also, one thing I did was, remember our test piece from a little while ago? I'm gonna spray my clear coat on this and I'm gonna dump it on just to see if it reacts or does something weird or if it crinkles. That way, if it does, then I know that I'm gonna have to be extra careful. But if it doesn't react or anything, then I know I'm pretty good shape. So once again, test piece comes in really handy in a spot like this. But just be very careful with spray can clear, because once you screw it up, it's a nightmare to fix. So the best way to not screw it up is to do it right the first time. So let's get started. I joke when I say don't paint stuff on your car. It's generally a bad idea, but I kind of don't joke at the same time. If you're gonna do anything paint-wise with your car, you've gotta take some time and really think about what you're gonna do, and take your time and remember, especially with a newer vehicle, that you're not painting the whole car. Less is more. Okay, the more you start modding out your car and start painting all the trim and all something, you know, all sorts of crazy things, is when the whole color scheme starts going awry and it looks bad. So if you do small things, like I did with my headlight rings, it's really cool. It gives it a very subtle and kind of that head turning look just for a second. You're like, hey, wait, that's a little bit different than the ones I've seen, but that's it. As soon as you start going crazy is when it starts getting out of control. So a really cool, subtle look by just painting the headlight rings on my Sonic. Now, of course, I didn't come up with the idea myself. I'd love to hang out at the Sonic Owners Forum, and some guys had some great ideas about painting their headlight rings different colors and things. And I also got a chance to see what it looked like with a white car before I did it. So I just wanted to share with you a fun project really quick. You can apply this to all sorts of vehicles and different ideas, but I'm really just trying to spark the ideas that you can do for super cheap and are just super fun. So if you got any questions, you know where to check us out. CommandoDesigns.com. I'm Tony D.